G7 a stage for US to realize its own hegemonic agenda, analysts. Hiroshima, the Japanese city once flattened by an atomic bomb, was packed with foreigners during the G7 summit, which lasted for 3 days from May 19. These foreigners did not go there for sightseeing. Rather, they traveled a long way from home with the sole purpose of protesting the imperialist nature of G7 members, as well as America's outsized role in the geopolitics of the Asia-Pacific region. Placards held by both local and foreign demonstrators were filled with slogans such as "No War on China" and "US out of Asia-Pacific," echoing a growing consensus among international observers who have been alarmed by Washington's increasingly hostile stance on Beijing. Observers pointed out that the U.S., which accuses China of economic coercion, is in fact the one who has pressured its allies to team up against what it considered its greatest rival. The U.S. is attempting to rally its allies to strengthen its presence in the Asia-Pacific region through the G7 summit, Saeb Rawashta, a political analyst at the Jordan Press Foundation, told China Media Group, CMG. It is also trying to provoke conflicts and create chaos in the region, Rawashta said. A joint statement produced by the G7 summit was replete with rhetoric China believed was aimed to curb its economic growth and interfere with its internal affairs. But that was only the latest example of the U.S. overextending its hand in Asia-Pacific affairs. It followed a long list of actions, including pushing for a trilateral military alliance with both Japan and South Korea, as well as incorporating the Quad partnership into its Indo-Pacific strategy with the aim of weakening China. Also to be noted was Japan's attempt to abandon decades of pacifism and make itself a true military power, as UK magazine Time concluded in a recent article. This attempt was reinforced during the summit as Tokyo sensationalized challenges to the liberal and open world order, and played the role of a critical supporter for such a world order, one who defends it against rising challenges when the US and Western countries as a whole gradually lose their advantage in face of the international power shift. Sun Wenju, an associate research fellow at the China Institute of International Studies, wrote in an op-ed published by CGTN. Japan's maneuvers, while destabilizing to the region, are an effort endorsed, even encouraged by the U.S., who is obsessed with maintaining its hegemony and primacy by mobilizing resources from allies, Sun added. Tensions and divisions are stirred up when the G7 countries shun away from cooperation and impose their political ideologies and economic beliefs on others, a result engendered by U.S. manipulations and reflected in the summit's economic security agenda, according to analysts. Also alarming to observers was the summit's intrusion in the Taiwan question, as well as a visit to the island made last week by former UK Prime Minister Liz Truss, who followed an example made by then US House Speaker Nancy Pelosi in August. It can be seen from a series of G7 agendas that the meeting called for the Western world to strengthen sanctions against Russia, and at the same time to be defensive against China, attempting to bind these two together, Su Xiaohui, an associate researcher at the China Institute of International Studies, told CMG. Based on the negative practices by the US and Japan, this year's G7 summit does not provide the region and the international community with proactive cooperation and development opportunities, but challenges and hidden dangers, Su said.